This morning's adventure is to investigate the Gua Garba, which is the riverside temple below and to the east of the Purupungukuran, which I visited last week, which is up here. So on the suggestion of Gadat Kam, Parakan Purasamwantiga, I have to climb down this riverbank and find the footprint of Kobo Iwa, the legendary mystical giant who carved out Gua Gaji with his fingernail. Now this is the Patanu River down here. It's very special, particularly to the cults of the 9th, 10th century, the Ayatlanga era. We have many famous temples along this river, including Samwantiga. Of course, the Purupanatharansase is just down the road, and Tampaksiring is a wonderful water source up the hill. And I also visit Puramanganing, which is related to Purupungukurukur later on today. Oh, how fabulous! Barely 200 meters down the hillside, you come across this extraordinary 10th century looking gate which leads to the Gua, which may have been a meditation cave. What an exquisite setting! Someone has fashioned this magical, romantic, poetic garden with a lone betel nut tree. Lovely little area with a bench and a little simple brook and those lovely stones. Wow, there's only one ghastly andesite shrine in evidence. So these stairs lead up to the Purupungukurukuran. I see how they've copied the faux doorways, the left and right of this magnificent edifice, this magnificent gateway, on the Prasada at the Purupungukuran. It's a little bit of a crime against geology and theology over here. Ah! Da 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 da! Brontosaurus transformer architecture invades the medieval splendor. What sort of a person would do that? Oh, how magical! These meditation caves. There's a sign up forbidding Pra Wed videos. And that goes down to the riverbanks there. Gee, would have been nice being a Buddhist priest in this hermitage. Unusual, almost a single post-meditation pavilion in the center there. Never seen that before, of the type one finds on the Islam Majapahit reliefs, signifying asceticism. Of course, there were 50,000 ascetics in the hills of Java in the 15th century, according to Tomes Perez. Perez! So these are the stairs coming down from the Purupungukurukuran temple and corralled off. Is the footprint of legendary mystical giant Kobo Iwa, who was actually a general in the Majapahit Empire. Looks like it's a bit of rock has flaked off Ampura, but out of her, for that skeptical comment. But of course, Kobo Iwa was 500 years after this temple was built, I think. This complex, this could have been the gate to a monastery or the eastern entrance to Purupungukurukuran. Mercifully, no one's built a villa on the other banks. And there's a patirtha and a sort of bedji. Somehow this reminds me of Candi Panataran. 13th, 14th century Majapahit temple, but rumored to have earlier antecedents, hard to have later antecedents, which has a wonderful Beji Patirthan sort of complex outside, but also just behind and below the temple on the banks of the river. Agamatirtha, the religion of the holy waters, is the name for the religious cult of Bali, and Hindu Dharma is firmly based in Agamatirtha, Java as well. The Patirtha are from above and to the north. See the Makala Naga spouts. There's a pump. I wonder if that pump pumps up holy water to the temple above, probably. It's such a pretty valley. I wonder if John Darling ever got here. He would have loved this. Thinking about John Darling all the way up, but this was very much his area. Christine Yoman Lempard having come from Pejeng originally. Another interesting part of the complex. Below a small modern shrine. This looks as though it could have had water pouring out here, and it could have been a Pramandian for people, and then just to the south is a special Beji or Patirthaan. So there seem to be these large sundi. Maybe this used to have a roof over it at some time. There's sort of column plinths there with a hole in the top. Could have been a giant. There's another one here. And if you look over here, we find the... Dear, those andesite shrines really are offensive. And this could have been... Seems to be partitioned off. Now, one would think male, female, but one could also think, oh, they've got Ganesha spouts. How magical. Ganesha spouts does sort of date things to the 10th century. Could have been one section for Beji holding water, one section for humans. I'm going to just get my head splashed under that to ask permission of the local god. What a great tree. I forget what that tree is called. It's not a pole, but it seems to be self-sown in a magical position. Closer view of the Ganesha spout with a linga next to it. This seems to be another sort of Ganesha. This one's lost its spout. Inside the Guha Garbha meditation cave, we find the magical stones which are always rearranging themselves. According to Garat Kam, maybe there's a naughty monk with it rearranges them. But this seems to be a... Could have been a stepped pinnacle or a faux prasada roof that would have been a panel on some decorative element of the cave. It's a very important Buddhist vessel there. Again with a stepped stupa like the linga, a strange the linga decorative element in the style of the rather modern looking Aksara, the old Bali Java script writing which is above the cave. A very special inscription above the cave, and there's another one on the roof of the could be a Soka Tunggal. It really looks like a meditation pavilion where the meditators would have somehow, right, impossibly, they must have sat either side in the lotus position. So it's not symbolic of a single post pavilion. It's just a little two niche cave meditation sort of platform with a pavilion top. Fascinating. Next door, the magic stands. Up above, the Guagaraba gate to Porapunuku Ukuran and the monster Brontosaurus Transformer Shrine. I've asked my guide Anton to demonstrate, him being of the sort of 10th century size of a Balinese Javanese. And you can Nusantara Kambali. NJ. Pamit. Ya bagus. Hindu revival ritual by young Jember Anton. Thank you, Anton. Love your work. So leaving the beautiful Guagaba, we come across the ghastly front edifice of the restored to within an inch of its life edifice of the Porapunuku Ukuran, and we're heading up to Pura Manganing, sister temple of Porapunuku Ukuran in near Tampaksiring, near Gunung Kawi, which may or may not be the resting place or the cremation ground or the Padarmaan. What do they call it in India? I forget. Of Udayana's family, including Adlanga, his son. It's a very beautiful area. I mean, the riverside was magnificent. Kiri Banjardinas Gepokan. Looks like a nice road too. What a lovely area. A great place for a Sunday drive. Here's the Villa Bella. There's a nice big temple in there too. Temples everywhere. This is a very important area in the classical era. Everything's called a classical era that evokes mystery. I've just seen this temple out of the corner of my eye, which looks very special. Just a lovely red brick Chandi Bantad, very like the one I saw this morning on the old palace, now the Makam of Sunan Kudus. We'll just have a look in here, it looks very special. Looking for the name of the temple. It's a very lovely Chandi Bantad. So graceful. And maybe Lempard bought this very slender, graceful aesthetic to Ubud. Certainly his gate for the Pura Desa in Ubud is a masterpiece of economy and beauty. It's the Pasamuan there in the middle. It's the sort of mountain style to have a big Pasamuan. In Pliatan they have a big Pasamuan. Just like that. And the Gedong is next, which is rather discreet. And there's shrines to Gunung Labah and Gunung Agung. But here, in the northeast corner, is a very special monolith called Sapta Patala. Beautiful signage. And there's a beautiful long stone. Oh, isn't that stunning? Very beautiful. Arlangange. Wenten sumur sarang. Okay, the next part of the morning adventure is going down and looking for the Chandi Tabing in this exquisite valley just south of Tampaksiring. But the path has diverged and one wouldn't want to have to walk back up, but I'm sensing it's down here to the north. Anyway, I want to see that view up the valley. We took the right path, the farmer advised us. Wow, I think that whole valley has been an amazing complex of meditation caves, but the one in particular, the famous Chandi Tabing, is over here. And as predicted by Lingard Saputra Wayan, the charismatic Kuta photographer that has the same roof as the Purupumapuru Quran. So that solves the mystery a bit. Not totally. So the river Patanu and the famous Chandi Tabing. Have to go over there, I guess. Yeah, we found the wondrous Chandi Tabing. Krobokan, I always thought it was in Krobokan. Krobokan in Changu. It's not at all. Been saying that wrong for 30 years. Editors. I wonder if the Patanu River, what another gorgeous park. Oh my God, another giant staircase. What were they thinking in the 10th century? These giant treads. Manetipi! Ah, Wooktipi, she said, am I going to be on the television? I said, yes, dear, and she said, it'll be completely fucked, the television, if I'm on it. Woog. Woog, woog, which means, like, the result of a tsunami. I'll get shocked making this dirty talk in front of the temple. So there it is, the famous Chandi. Looks as if it's been a bit restored, but it's more handsome than the one at Ukur. And there's the sacred spring where you can't wash, and there's a big Patirtaan bathing spot down here. What a beautiful complex. Been here 42 years and didn't know about it. It's a wonderful bathing spot. Come, there's even some spunks down there. So we found the prasada at the Pura Manganing. It's got a very Majapahit Pejeng style Chandi Bantar. And inside a Transformer Brontosaurus, Chandi Bantar, tight little courtyards. And the Chandi Tabing style, yuck. Mercifully, the central prasada is unrestored. That beautiful, it would have had water around that. I don't think so originally though. From this cement look, I think they've just kept the original base exposed. It's not pooping in a puddle. Pretty grotesque Prabhus carved and gilt altar boxes, shrine boxes. And over here the old form of the Sakararas that you find at Katewal and many old temples with the little wall around it. This one at Sutar. Beautiful. It's a lovely old sort of mobile piazza, and for someone with a couple of nagas. The nagas are very special. This bali is called a bali pachanangan, bali pasalang. The padaraksa forms, these bantalas, are really antique and gorgeous. Low tembok penyangkar, panggungan. This one's really nice, the Dagoba style on top. See how if you split that down the middle, you get the Chandi Bantar. I was looking at a photo of Chandi Chitor, the last of the Majapahit temples in Java, and it's a sort of split form of this more squat mountain. So the stairs of the prasada are going very reminiscent of Chandi Jawi. Thank you. sets of stairs at Chandi Jawi and at some stepped shrines in Singaraja. This is called the Prasada Agung. But from the corbelling, the coursework really is very like the Singasari style of Chandi Jawi. Which was, of course, much copied by Ida Bagus Tulgur. It seems to have had a renovation. Some of the old stone is there, maybe from after the 1917 earthquake. And then there's a more recent restoration, which is less sensitive. They've got the old lentil stone there. And the roof, which is quite Star Trek looking. But you can see how this old 10th century look, or the Singasari look, has influenced this modern andesite look, which is, you know, this is the more the Majapahit look here. This was, of course, all championed by Ida Bagus Tulgur, who famously did the art centre. Wow, that's a really old, rather Majapahit-looking statue. Plingi Ratu Pungura. So reminiscent of Chandi Jawi. Chandi Jago, as it's sometimes called. Jago. Outside Singasari, I'll be there in a couple of weeks. I can compare notes. This is the Paruman Agung, which is a form you find in the ancient Singaraja temples. Interesting sandi, bollards on the Majapahit style again. Dagoba style slightly. There's the main Prasada Agung, flanked by the Plingi Ratu Pungura Agung. Those gorgeous staircases. This is the Pasamuan. There's the Pachanangan Bali in the distance. And the lovely old Majapahit style Panyankar visible. All the dulangs are piled up here in the Bali Pachanangan. Unusual square plan, 4 taban, 12 poster. This is a rather cute little Unyil miniature Bali kukul. Doesn't really help having Anton there for scale because he's only 3 feet tall.
I'm a Mexican.
Munch.
I'm a Mexican.
Munch.
Munson.
Munch.
Munch.
Munchkin.
Munchkin.
Yeah, I am a munchkin.
I am a munchkin.
Welcome to the kulkul.
Welcome to the kulkul.
Right, there's the holy beji, the patirtan, there's the parmandian, there's a lovely decorative pond for the goldfish. A wonderful complex. This beautiful tree. There's the men's complex, and here's the ladies' complex. There's a raging river water source in the middle. Look at those giant bay lele. I love that the river runs through it and makes this incredible aquatic display with the naga spouts. Ah, Nusadua Beach, it's your heart out. And you've got recreation and spunks. I better get down there quick. Right, I've got the Tampaksiring boys showing off. Sira Danpa'a. Sira? Putu Sira. Put a Robert. Oh, Del again. Ali Chavik Bule. Quat yung ayin. Kinkin quat ne. Look at this fabulous bathing spot. I can't believe it took 42 years to find this place. A mud maker play for the caddy. But if I do, I'm telling you true. That my heart belongs to Daddy. What an amazing little valley of joy. Oh, and the water was incredible. This is the delightful road that parallels the main Pejeng Tampaksiring road. And the architecture is still delightfully Asli. Such a delightful country road with villages, spotted with villages of beautiful architecture. Classic Bali. The real Bali still lives north of Pejeng on the back road past the Pura Pumukurukuran. You can go to Chandi Tebing. You can come out at Pura Manganing and have the best mandi in this beautiful bathing spot. When I take my summer vacation, this is where I wanna be. Far away from civilization, in classic Bali. Whoop, now we dive down into another village littered with blossoming yellow frangipanis. The gates are high left and right of the road, as they often are in these villages high up the slopes of Gunung Batur. Still happening. Put a machete. There's everything here. There's krobokans, machetes, tubings. Just gorgeous landscape. Architecture sublime. Still pretty. I see there's an old popolung adobe gate. So even when they rebuild, look at these people having the life of up here in the Bali Patok, overlooking rice fields. God, let's hope the real estate villa people don't find this. Water features everywhere. Bits of patches of verdant jungle. Down we go. And anywhere you go down on the east to the left of this road, incredible springs and the lovely Pekrisan of the Patano River. Up, up we go. Another sensational village. Oops. Look at this pretty sangha on a row. Just classic. Classic beauty, left and right for 2 or 3 miles. Ah, oh, look at this pretty one. Oh, stop, Malua, I got back on here. Gee, you guys found the good spot. It's a wonderful road. Old classic Balinese villages. You found a good spot to stop. There's a beautiful bathing spot up. You're going up that way, you're going downhill. We'll have a look at the Chandi Tubing. It's a sign on, no, Gua Garba. Gua Garba, there's a big temple with a very ugly black andesite stair with a couple of dragons. Very, very visible on the left of the road. Just there's a little lane after that. It's called Chandi Gua Garba. And you go down the stairs and there's an old 10th century monastery. And there's a wonderful spot there to have a swim. There you go. Yeah. No, it's not a big walk. Yeah, the bikes, I suppose you can leave them at the Wairong. Okay, bye. Nice people. Look, you've got nice tourists up here. Hanging out there. Dulcet tones of the day-feeding marsupial. My country women. Country people. Duwagi ali jalan ya. Ada guide nama ada. Sing to port. Stop, Malu. Wow, that's a beauty. So we've stopped at this stunning village because this temple gate has caught my eye. Just us two. Ah, what a classico. The little truncated Aling Aling. Very pretty gate. So simple and stylish. So I'm in the temple now, and it's got inscribed 1963, 7th of December. It's a very handsome temple, very simple. It's lovely. Paruman in the center, Lingi. Some very special little singers. Probably the Sindhi, the singers are probably older than 1965, because the Barnleys tend to reuse the Sindhi from the old. What a special little pinnacle on this shrine with the four Garudas, Garuda Punkur, and a Dagoba in the center in the Pejeng style. It's the homeowner in the village of, village, that's an upi, Nikki? Nikki? Pungambungan. It's a lovely old Matan. Nibiche Sakanama. Karima and keep. Dong Popolan up here, Dani Bata, Bata Chitakan, eh? Kari Bata Chitakan. It's the Mona Sami, Panikin, eh? Kuri, eh? Uncle Uncle, eh? Mungkin ampun, tapi bagus desa ini potongannya masih Bali kui, masih klasik, harus dilestarikan. What a lovely little sign. The adventure continues. This nice man here. Sira dan pa. Agung sira. Agung kembar, wenten kembar ne?
Kembar ne, ya kale.
Kale, kembar.
Kembar kale.
Persis.
Persis kene.
Dijeragane. Moso, nomor berapa?
Saya nomor terakhir.
Tan ne kembara, ampun lebar.
Ampun.
Waktu di karya lid.
Karya lid ampun kali.
Di lekat ne.
Tan ampun 6 bulan ampun kali.
Aduh, kali ne kan kembar ne. He lost his twin brother when the when he was 6 months old. Wow, oh this is wow. Ni cara ada vihara demun ne. Vihara ne ki. Ada gua di tu cara gua gajah ne. That's definitely been a monastery down there. Nikitan masuk tapi dulu ada pasti ada atapnya dulu kan. It's very pretty though. What a beautiful valley. Tongos manjus luang.
Manjus ada ni manjus luang.
Nee, mempidan mai manjus.
Manjus luang.
Ya ampun.
Bo ada dah salah bo 15 tahun baru.
Oh, 15 years ago they uncovered this. Berarti masih banyak juga kan?
Masih banyak.
Mungkin ini seperti apa ada ni ke seperti serado kan tempat menanam abu na zaman pidong eh semadi kalau di India namanya kan ya tempat pesarean kalau di Jawa mungkin abunya zaman dulu kan cari kemulan raja.